Here's an idea. You are what you share, literally. I want to talk about me right now. I don't mean like literally me. Wait, no, actually I do mean literally me, just not literally me. Okay, this got very confusing very quickly. Let's start over. I want to talk about this thing that happens on the internet. In Instagram comments, on Twitter and Tumblr, other places, I'm sure, where in response to an image or a piece of text, either the person posting, reblogging, or retweeting it, or other people commenting on it, will write me RN for me right now, or literally me, or same, or GPOI, or quick selfie. A post about the difficulties of being productive? Me right now. A koala being served in the first class cabin? Literally me. Overheated cat in front of the fan? Hashtag GPOI. P. Diddy doesn't want to get out of bed? Baymax inspecting his gut truth, coming out of her well to shame mankind? Same. It may go without saying, but as is generally my wont, I'm gonna say it anyway. It's pretty unlikely the person on the other side of the internet posting said literally me's is literally truth coming out of her well to shame mankind. So, grammatical pet peeves notwithstanding, what's actually literally going on here? For now, we're gonna focus mostly on the image-related instances of this practice where the main ingredient is maybe just a picture is worth a thousand words. There is something about truth and her well that perfectly captures some mood which, if tasked to put it into words, one would no doubt struggle. And so easiest is just to point at her and go, this, me, that's me, I feel the way that she looks. This is also the basic premise, I think, of the related but distinct use of reaction gifs. In response to some situation, the reaction gif communicates much more nuance than simply typing lol or using an emoji, but their general use is more widespread than what we're talking about now. Basically, some me right nows are reaction gifs, but not all reaction gifs are me right nows. I also think there's a dash of pics or it didn't happen in this me right now stew. A raccoon relaxing on a stairwell railing captioned me RN, or a Taylor Swift Instagram where someone has commented me when The Walking Dead comes on, doesn't prove anything, but it does provide an external visual reference for complex internal emotions. It makes an individual subjectivity more concrete, sometimes even just to themselves, no audience necessary. It's not just that the raccoon looks a little dejected, but that it's also small and fuzzy and in some large, well-lit, bland, industrial, or corporate setting. It's not just that Taylor is excited, it's that she's also a glamorous celebrity. When all of these elements, whatever they are, come together and match someone's current or expected internal state, it can be a sudden and cathartic distillation, almost an exorcism. Yes, that is me! A reaction gif provides a reaction to a situation, but a person reacts to whatever they label literally me. But okay, cathartic self-recognition in art or media isn't news. We have all had Nico weekends or Rothko mornings, girl talk afternoons, and Agnes Martin seasons. What's novel here is how it plays alongside our internet disembodiment. We are able, thanks to the post button, to let images stand in for our own physicality where we don't actually have one. Sitting around in Meatspace, you may listen to Elliott Smith or LMFAO and turn to your friends and be like, I feel this way right now. But that song isn't acting for you in any way. I guess maybe unless you learn to play it. Posting literally me below an image collapses not all, but at least some of that space. The image acts for you, at least a little bit, and if done regularly or over time, one can create some multifaceted, always under construction, always unfolding four-dimensional internet body in images, where one might at different times be a fox, a celebrity, a cartoon character, or some descriptive bit of text. Which is to say, via the internet, one has some unique image-centric capability to be always becoming themselves. This works in sort of the same way that Facebook might. You can construct an identity out of a carefully pruned and managed set of images so that you're totally guaranteed to get that job at the hedge fund or whatever. But the differences are apparent. The Facebook norm is to curate photos of one's actual face. In contrast, the distributed body constructed via images on Twitter and Tumblr and even on Instagram through the use of same and me right now can be comprised of any and all faces, and even occasionally not faces. On Facebook, self-identification is, for most people, still anchored to one's physical, actual body. Outside of Facebook, one need not necessarily draw a direct connection to their embodied self. In a weird way, constructing ourselves from a set of images referencing our own physical existence can be limiting. The limiting factors are ones of availability, accuracy, and even privacy. Where there is less of an emphasis on the physical self, there weirdly can be a stronger emphasis on what someone might feel is some more accurate, poetic, actual self divorced from or simply parallel to physicality. That process can be a casual one, made mostly of offhanded jokes about how you literally are some set of things that you really literally aren't, but which you feel some connection, even if momentary. It can be fleeting and experimental, or that process can be involved and serious, where the idea of self is very much related to collection, curation, reaction to, and advertisement of certain images. I see this most often in really active fandoms, where media images help form both a personal and community identity. Most readily, from the outside, meaning I could be totally wrong on this, this seems like how it works in the furry fandom, that there is a set of media, some of it custom made for this purpose, which contributes to a representation of each particular fur, and that representation, to different degrees for different furs, is a more accurate or simply more enjoyable version of themselves. It is thus their fursona. And all that media which contributes to the creation of individual fursonas works to create a collective, constantly shifting idea of what fursonas are or can be. And I know that there are a good number of furs who watch Idea Channel, so I would love to know if this is at all accurate. I think that there are similar, though perhaps less involved, versions of this process that occur around fan blogs for TV shows and YouTubers for anime, and occasionally, though in my experience not nearly as frequently, video games. In Understanding Media, Marshall McLuhan writes that, quote, "All media are active metaphors in their power to translate experiences into new forms. The spoken word," he writes, "was the first technology by which man was able to let go of his environment in order to grasp it in a new way." Is it possible that now, image gathering and self-identification by it is a metaphor for personality? McLuhan goes on to discuss how in the information age, we as people are being translated into data and information. People in that translation become extended by their technology, except where once that technology would extend our reach, our hand, it is now capable of extending our will, ourselves. In addition to using the internet and its related technology to act, we can now see how it's used to be. Instead of, or in addition to, information technology translating a pre-existing person, it's possible to see how facets of that person could be constructed with that technology. Of course, as important and powerful as the internet and its technologies seem, they do not literally sustain us. They aren't consumable resources powering biological processes, but they can be and are important social, psychological assets. French psychoanalyst and philosopher Jacques Lacan argued that the unconscious is structured like language, specifically that it makes use of two devices, mostly metaphor and metonymy. The unconscious is a seeming jumble, but there is an actual system of meaning being created, just unconsciously. Conscious ideas, memories, and images combine, replace, and stand in for other unconscious ideas, memories, and images in our search, Lacan said, much like Freud, to fulfill some complicated desire, some lack that we experience in ourselves. From a certain view, you literally are the metaphors which structure your unconscious. Which is to say that though you may not literally be Truth coming out of her well to shame mankind, in some sense, her image might be literally you? What do you guys think? Are you literally, in some way, the things that you share? Do you feel some kind of important or powerful process of self-construction when you hit the post or reblog or retweet button? Let us know in the comments, and I will respond to some of them in next week's comment response video. In this week's comment response video, we talk about your thoughts regarding the Tommy Westfall universe hypothesis and the purpose of fan theories. If you want to watch that one, you can click right here or find a link in the doobly-doo. And if you happen to miss the announcement last week, Idea Channel now has a t-shirt. If you want to buy that, you can click right here. Ding! This week's episode is brought to you by the hard work of these truths coming out of their wells to shame mankind. We have a Facebook, an IRC, and a subreddit. Links in the doobly-doo. And the tweet of the week comes from Shake Well, who points us towards two different and somewhat opposing takes on fan theories.